Hello again, I'm Jake Saunders, your host, and welcome back to Retro TV, the show where we draw from the past to create the future. This time we're looking at retro food, a trend that never seems to go out of style. We'll be looking at retro food from each decade and why it's all so popular today. We'll also have a cooking demonstration and a visit to the Soda Rock Diner, and we'll show you how to plan your own retro-themed dinner party. So let's get into it.
It is an open secret that most humans love food. Every corner of the planet has its unique culinary tastes and cuisine, formulated over years of human evolution. Wherever you go, the smell of food coming from the cafe on the corner is certainly going to entice you in and make you feel warm and cozy. Yet often you find people yearning for a blast from the past. And food is a simple way to relive the years gone by. The primary reason why retro food is so popular is because of the nostalgic feeling it evokes. People find the familiarity in their culinary experience very comforting. The experience triggers pleasant and cherished memories of food prepared by older relatives. The simplicity of food from the past offers a feeling of security and satisfaction. It can remind us of a childhood we left all those years ago. There is also a big demand for food that is made with low-cost ingredients, is easily shareable, and has lots of flavor. After all, a bland dish feels uninspired, and often recipes of old can feel lively due to a fresh 21st century experience. Some can even feel wacky, especially considering certain trends that should stay in the past. I know I'd rather have some beef stroganoff over ham and banana hollandaise myself. The demand for fresh and exciting recipes was very prominent during lockdowns, when people were experimenting with different recipes and methods of cooking. Old recipe books, the first thing off the shelf to satisfy a curiosity or boredom. The demand for the comfort those culinary experiences create certainly persists today.
Now, there is a bit of overlap with the decades, but that's just because retro food just never seems to go out of style. Starting with the 50s, we've got deviled eggs, meatballs, beef stroganoff, cocktail frankfurts, Viennese tarts, jam roly-poly, Arctic rolls, and Bombay Alaska. In the 60s, there's chicken boulevards, cheese and cucumber sandwiches, steak and kidney pie, potato and leek soup, flavored jellies, bread and butter puddings, trifles, and pineapple cake. Dancing into the 70s, we had jaffle chips with chicken salt, beef Wellington stroganoff, muesli bars, chocolate crackles, cheese fondue, and a Perugia fruit salad. Dancing away into the 80s brought us scotch eggs, prawn cocktails, potato salad, sesame prawn toast, chocolate roulet, profiteroles, black forest cake, and the vanilla slice. And into everyone's favorite decade in the 90s brought us popular foods including apricot chicken, fish fingers, meatloaf, chicken schnitzel, mud cake, berry bread, and LCM bars. And we'd have to mention the 90s king on the top of that list, the Lamington. All this talk of food is making me hungry. Luckily, we're about to go cook a quiche Lorraine. And we're here. So I can finally now get some of that delicious quiche Lorraine or Laurent in my belly. I don't even know how to pronounce it. I swear I get two different things every time. I'm going to now cook up some of this food, but not before I wash my hands.
Whoa, slow down there, Posh Jake. We haven't told them what our ingredients are, you dummy. To make a quiche Lorraine, it is important to have the following on hand. First is our pastry sheets. You can make your own dough, but for simplicity, pastry sheets are just hard to beat. Next, you'll need a large brown onion, finely diced and ready to go. Follow that up with roughly 200 grams of bacon, diced to perfection. Can't go wrong with a decent slice of your favorite block of cheese, not diced, but grated. Hope you have some chickens on standby because you're going to need at least 8 eggs. You also need half a cup of cream to mix it all together in the end. And last but not least, have some butter, olive oil, flour, and water on standby. And who can forget our friends, salt and pepper. Now that the ingredients are covered, let's get back to cooking. First, wash your hands thoroughly, as we just don't want to get anyone sick. Then, we're going to heat up the oven to 200 degrees Celsius Grab yourself a flam pan and lightly grease the bottom of it. You can also use it as a guide to cut your pastry sheets into a circle. Then, using either the leftover bits of the pastry sheet you just used or using a new one, you can cut it into equal strips lengthwise. Line it up against the side of your flam pan and mold it until you form the outer layer of the crust, trimming the excess. Line the pastry case with baking paper and fill with ceramic pie weights. Side note, you can also use uncooked rice. Place it on the baking tray and bake for 20 minutes. While the pastry cooks, melt some butter in a large frying pan over medium heat and add a finely chopped brown onion and 200 grams of bacon, cooking and stirring for about 5 minutes or until the bacon is golden and crisp and the onion is softened. One of the great things about quiches is that they're so versatile. You can add all kinds of ingredients to it, such as chopped asparagus and sliced mushrooms for extra nutrition and flavor. Now let's put all the fried ingredients in a bowl and set it aside for 10 minutes to cool. In the meantime, let's prepare for the final step. Grab your 8 eggs and a half a cup of pure cream and whisk them in a bowl together. Once thoroughly mixed, set that mixture aside. Now let's return to our pastry. Take it out of the oven very carefully and use mitts to make sure you don't get burnt. Remove the weights and bake for a further 5 minutes or until the pastry turns gold. While you're down there, reduce the temperature to 160 degrees Celsius. Spoon the fried mixture into a pastry case and sprinkle with grated cheese of your choice. Then take your mixture and pour it all over the top. Don't forget to season with salt and pepper. Finally, we bake the quiche for 45 minutes or until set. Make sure to let it cool for 5 minutes before serving. And that's it. Doesn't that just look delicious? Now, of course, cooking isn't for everyone. So if you're hankering for some retro food but don't know where to look, then stick around. We know a spot.
If you want the best retro dining experience when you're out and about, look no further than the Soda Rock Cafe at the Jam Factory in South Yarra. Formerly named Johnny Rockets, this 50s-themed diner has something for everyone and has been a popular filming location for music videos, commercials, and other film and television content. Upon entering the diner, you'll be instantly transported back in time. The black and white tiling, the U-shaped counter, and the vintage red leather booths equipped with mini jukeboxes all make you feel like you're in 50s America. The diner also features a pinball machine, Coca-Cola prints on the walls, and a statue of Elvis Presley. The diner's menu includes authentic American burgers and hot dogs, as well as many different flavors of milkshakes, served with extra malted milk. The wait staff will even bring you your meal on roller skates, making dining at Soda Rock such a unique and amazing experience. Come down to Soda Rock today and let the good times roll.
Sorry, I didn't see you there. My name's Aiden O'Carter, and in today's episode of Retrofit, we're going to be planning the perfect 80s dinner party. We're gonna need some great music, some great dress code, and most importantly, a fantastic menu of 80s drinks and food. Let's get started.
It's very important to get the atmosphere right, and music is a big part of that. Let's put on our 80s playlist, and don't forget about adding ABBA. As for the dress code, make sure you wear some vibrant 80s colours and hairstyles. Looking good there, handsome.
But most importantly, 80s themed food and drink.
We'll start with some snacks. We've got smoked salmon on dill pikelets, an excellent and easy entree. We've also got homemade French onion dip with biscuits. For our drinks, we've got pina coladas. One pina colada is just 50 ml of rum, 75 ml of pineapple juice, and 25 ml of coconut cream. Add some pineapples into the mix. And some glacé cherries for garnish. For those who don't drink alcohol, you can always go for the classic soda. For our main course, we have our quiche Lorraine from before, which we'll serve with spinach on top. For dessert, we've got a chocolate ripple cake, which is super easy to make. Delicious! Now, let's set the table before the guests arrive.
Well, it looks like the dinner party was a big success. If you want to go and see all the recipes from today, you can go check out our website. I'm now going to go back to the party. Thank you for watching.
And that's all we have time for this week, unfortunately, but next week we'll be diving into the world of fashion. I cannot wait. Make sure you follow us on Instagram at retro.television.31 and sign up to our newsletter with the website here. I'm Jake Saunders, and we'll see you next time on Retro TV.